Svechnikov goes corner, gets the puck back. Brent Burns, the shot. Holmark sees it all the way. Brent Burns keeps it on the line to Aho, and Stefan Nason.
Yeah, and a rare power play goal in recent games for these Carolina Hurricanes. And again, we just talked about it. You got to get the clears when you have the opportunity. Holmark makes the save, and he punches it out into an area where you got to get to that puck, and you got to be hard on it and get it the length of the ice. Good effort by Brent Burns at that point position to keep that play alive. Long stick, long reach, keeps it inside the offensive zone, and it's a rebound chance.
Zacha slows down the puck for Krejci. He winds inside. Zacha! A save by Kochetkov.
Raj David Krejci. Nice little cut back into the middle. Protects the puck. Allows the puck to stay out in front of him in order to finish off.
Pesci let it get to the neutral zone. Seth Jarvis. Kotkaniemi closes. Jarvis walks in. A save by Omark. It's a goal. Jesperi Kotkaniemi.
Way down, and it's a quick right back into the offensive zone. Kotkaniemi with a drop pass. Jarvis can whip it. He's got a great shot. He tries to go blocker side. It looked like Omark lost track of where that puck ended up. It didn't go behind the net and score it out the other side. It kind of stayed towards the middle. Kotkaniemi was still there. He was able to get to that puck.
Scales it out. DeBrusque turns the corner, and Kotkaniemi.
Kotkaniemi rides up and catches him in the face, cuts him. He'll go for four. Prior to that was this individual effort by Jake DeBrusque. And this is a good opportunity to do that 4-on-3.
Jordan Staal wins the opening draw, and Brett Pesci lines it into the Carolina bench. Marchand back to McAvoy facing Jordan Staal. Marchand to Bergeron. A save by Kochetkov. 5-on-3 now. Pasternak out of the box. Slides it to Krejci right through the crease. Marchand to Krejci, a save by Kochetkov, and another on the toe.
As a result of that, Krejci looking for Bergeron. That just misses. Bruins again attack the net this time. It's Marchand for the redirect by Krejci.
Pesci around the boards. Aho to Shea. A save by Omark. A clear by McAvoy. And a save robbing Aho by Omark.
Just kind of drifts right into it. That puck's labeled glove side. Omark able to get it.
Jordan Staal off a skate. Brett Pesci to the same corner. Pasternak to Krejci. Scores! A dogged forecheck produces the first Boston goal of the afternoon.
And in third, compete level raised. Physicality raised. Good force along the wall. Carolina vacates the defensive zone a little prematurely, thinking they have a chance to get out of their own end. Pasternak with that great effort. And then Krejci, he knows that once he settles this puck. Of course, Carolina to defend. I'm curious to see if that late goal in period two put a little doubt in Carolina, because that's what can happen when you've lost four straight.
Marchand, the nearest penalty killer. Kotkaniemi turns, and a save by Omark, and another off Jarvis.
Side when Jarvis had a little tough time in on the puck. But the Bruins do a decent job in terms of their structure and their formation. You know, that's a shot from outside the dot off the elbow.
Hall digs it loose. Nason gets it back. Shea to Pesci. A save by Omark. Another save. And Stefan denied. by Connor Clifton's dive on top of Ullmark, and Ullmark is not moving.
Linus Ullmark's going to head to the Bruins dressing room as a result of this sequence here. The shot from Pesci looked like he was going to tie it up and end the play right there. Doesn't happen. Has to get that one with the right pad. The second one with the right pad up. Nostrand. I thought it was Jarvis, but it was Stefan that gets the last chance. And in behind him, trying to take away the upper half of the net for his goaltender, is Connor Clifton.
McAvoy taps it ahead. Pasternak. Bergeron. Marchand, shot off the pipe!
Oh, by Charlie McAvoy to put this play in motion. Is that shot is kind of bouncing, and then it deflects, catches the crossbar and out.
Deflects to McAvoy. Marchand flattens it. Low for Hall, turns, and Kochetkov makes the save. Tosses it back to Lindholm. Lindholm's shot, a save by Kochetkov, a diving stab by Nick Foligno. Krejci shot, scores! No goal! Waved off.
Well, just as the penalty was expiring, Boston takes another opportunity to get a puck to the net. There's no contact there by Foligno. And usually you watch the goaltender's body language and his opinion. There was no complaint at all.
Look at Pesci's body language.
There's no question Foligno slides in there on his own. But there's the body contact by Pesci. Minimal contact against the goaltender. And it has to be conclusive in the replay to say, you know, whether this was a good goal or not. The call on the ice was emphatically a no.
After reviewing the play, it was determined that there was no goaltender interference.
Spins to the backhand. Charlie Coyle to Charlie McAvoy off his stick. 3-on-1. Swayman the save. Ball took the net off its pegs, getting back ferociously. Clifton batters it down to Zacha. Clifton, a save by Kochetkov. A floater out to the blue line. Last chance for Charlie McAvoy. DeBrusque going for the tip, and this game goes overtime.
Five hole underneath. Swayman denies him. The Bruins needed that save at that time, and they got it.
They'll play 4-on-4 until the next stoppage. Hall. Kochetkov has it in his glove.
The shot, and then Taylor Hall tried to do something himself and nearly pulled it off.
The puck skips off Marchand's stick. Brad Marchand. Pasternak scores! Boston wins! And the Bruins are the first team in NHL history to start the season 12-0 at home.
The way that they are winning, they get down 2-0 in this hockey game. It doesn't look great in the opening period. Periods 2-3 in overtime. Impressive what this team is able to do. And they take advantage of the power play. The penalty killing again, something they need to continue to work on. They're giving up power play goals, but their own power play is dynamic. And here it is again. Pasternak with a one-timer.
On the move through center, Tanev, he's a real stabilizer in the lineup. Mangiapane fires in a kick save for Kemper in goal. Dylan Strome wins the draw. Intercepting there was Blake Coleman. At point position, Weegar thunders away, stopped by Kemper. And the Flames will be squaring off with Carolina tomorrow. Canes are underway against Boston today, and two better as Kemper makes a shoulder and glove stop on an outside heater. Goals from Stefan Nason. Oshie looking for Alexei Protas. Taken to the backboards by Noah Hanifin, 25-year-old rear guard. Deep slot, Rister right on, and stopped by Markstrom. Bring it this way for Kadri. Nazem Kadri's Rister off the outside of the goal. Lindholm is next. He and Kadri below the goal line. Jensen there for Washington using the boards, not getting it clear. Saucer down low, pad save, Kemper. Rebounds off the outside of the post. Lucic rumbling into the zone. Gets wide, feeds that one off the shin pads of Irwin. Oshie counterpunching for Washington. Ovechkin leads Gustafsson into the zone. Nice kick up. Great pass. Score! Oshie on a phenomenal play from Gustafsson.
Beautiful pass. Watch Ovi put it into the seam there to Gustafsson. Collects it in his skate. Passes it to TJ and he rips it 5-hole past Markstrom. That play doesn't develop unless Ovi's able to make that seam pass. Gustafsson the Dean jumps into the rush, leading directly to an odd man break. He's 1-7-1 coming into this hockey game this afternoon.
Dylan Dubé on the overlap. Tanev fires, stop, rebound off the outside of the post. Nazem Kadri had his arms raised, ready to celebrate. Long drive from Gilbert, flagged down by Kemper. Has a 1-0 advantage over visiting Calgary. The Flames out of the Pacific Division. The Caps will be seeing a lot of that bracket. Kadri gets spun around immediately on the hit by Nick Dowd. Advancing down the wing for the snapshot. No worries for Kemper.
I mean, you just have to give it time, and Dmitry will be welcomed back with open arms once he's 100%.
Sherry fires. It's cuffed away by Markstrom. That one almost rolled away from him. Washington grabbing the lead. Oshie's third of the season from Gustafsson and Ovechkin. Just shy of the 8-minute mark. A point drive from Irwin. Punched down by Markstrom as he retreats to the crease. He finds it in the blue paint. On the wing, Coleman. Kicked it down the dasher. Lars Eller pressing out there defensively. Kemper paddle down, makes the stick save, and he will cover up. Shots on goal, as you could tell, top of the screen, favoring Calgary. Snapshot for another one, rejected by Kemper. He had the blocker pad up on Nazem Kadri. Mantha looks to clear. Anthony has terrific numbers against the Flames in his career. Little give-and-go interchange, caroms to the slot area. Anderson from point position keeps it alive. Zadorov, towering defender there for Calgary. 3:25 left in this opening period. Weegar fires and a pad save for Kemper. A long blast that's deadened in front and slapped clear by Weegar. Toffoli is onside. Toffoli is in through his forehand. Big save, Kemper, and he'll cover.
As he followed him across, look at him. Number one, he's challenging. Number two, it's the push to the right leg. And then he's got total coverage to the net. But the bouncing puck worked into the favor of the Caps there.
A couple of college kids there, right? Hathaway at Brown, Gilbert at Notre Dame. As we are in the McNugget minutes of this opening period, Kemper kneels to deny. Period. Gustafsson and Ovechkin set it up splendidly. We are off and running in the second with Gustafsson driving one in against the Calgary Flames, who come in with 21 points.
27-15 and had a 15-6 opportunity in shots.
Carlson closing. Passes to the front. Sherry didn't get the tip on that. Markstrom the save and the cover up. On his way down, not able to pull the trigger there.
That was a sweet move, actually, to elude Jensen there. Sort of a semi change of speed and fake shot there by Tyler Toffoli.
Jensen into the flow to the forehand, just rolled away from him. Sharp angle bit sent towards Markstrom from Oshie, and the ricochet winds up at center. Despite being doubled up in shots, as you can tell, top of the screen. Johansson to the point. Irwin blasts away. Kick out saved by Markstrom. Lars Eller gets the rebound, starts the cycle all the way to the point. Backhands one through the screen. Loose in front there. Markstrom made the save on Mantha.
That was a sweet move, too, by Anthony. Forehand. Here's the shot. Watch Mantha find himself. There's backhand, forehand. Just about a body blow through the blocker and the arm of the goaltender. But a real nice, sturdy stop there by Markstrom.
Elias Lindholm wrapped up. Measured well by Van Riemsdyk. Hanifin fires. That's shoulder high. Knocked down. Lewis on the turn. Stopped by Kemper. After today, the next six come on the road. Snapshot here from Eller. Stopped by Markstrom. Locker, did I see that right? Eller knocked the defender's stick away and then shot through it. Rescheduled at a later date.
Fellas, let's head to Tootsie's.
Irwin fires right to the breadbasket of Markstrom. Dylan Strom back. Carlson fakes it. Ovechkin fires it. Squeezed by Markstrom.
Sharp angle shot there. Had to get that puck around the defenseman there.
You know, if that was you, I'd probably try to close the door a little bit.
If you've ever missed it, if you've ever seen it, it looks like he's a ski jump.
He's high-stepping it.
Two on one. Rozicka fires. Stopped by Kemper. Rebounds loose. Richie denied as well. Goes indirect to Oshie. On the crisscross entry, push through a move there, score! A spectacular goal!
And it is indeed, buddy, spectacular, as you called it, one on three, and sliding down, hooks it around the goaltender. Here he is coming in, gets to his forehand, gets ripped down, and slides it underneath the right pad. A superstar goal by him.
Tangling with the Calgary Flames. Joe Beninati, Craig Laughlin upstairs. Al Koken, your ringside reporter. 2-0 for DC in this one with 20 minutes to go. Locker, how about the Boston Bruins? A thing of beauty, as my partner would say. Kuznetsov steps in, feeds. Oshie fires. He pumped it wide.
And he was going for his third point of this game this afternoon. TJ able to find a guy, and there's that shot. Nice let go of the quick release by TJ, and there it is. He's got some daylight. It looked like it hit the knob of the stick of the goaltender and went into the corner.
Nice keep in by Gustafson on the bouncing biscuit. Milano deflected that one wide. He was hovering in the slot. Cross ice. Ovechkin from skate to stick, he scores! Another brilliant kick up from the great eights.
Family glass side, give the glass a slap there for Alexander Ovechkin. What a shot that was. Connor missed it on the first one. He gets a good look here and then just rifles it. The first pass didn't get through, a mishandle. The second one, skate to stick, short side. Through the body, got a piece of Markstrom. Alex Ovechkin makes it 3-0.
Locker, earlier today we were talking about individual skill.
Zichka tried to put it over that left pad and just missed. What a stop.
On the Karamanthus behind the D in alone. Backhand stop. Rebound off the post.
He can't buy a break here in this hockey game. He could have a hat trick of all the pucks he's had when in the net here today. Of the way these guys hung together and played a hard brand of hockey, in particular the last 40 minutes, this will be the first time that Calgary Flames have been shut out this season. And Darcy gets a goose egg.
Was picked first overall. Big kid, 6'3", 240 pounds, only 18 years of age.
And by the way, that's last year, meaning last summer. In front and a score. Joel Edmondson taps it in. And Montreal is on the board early.
Little pass to the wing and then drives hard to the front of the net. He's got position on Tenorti, so he gets the stick down. Nice little pass by Sean Monahan. Joel Edmondson just redirects this one off the post and in.
McCabe. Pestered by Monahan. Monahan with the takeaway. Anderson saves. Soderblom. Brilliant. From Arvid. Arvid Soderblom. Flashing the leather like it's spring training. Keeps it a one-goal game. Anderson and Tenorti tangled up. Dvorak for Armia. Armia, another save by Soderblom.
Done a nice job of transitioning on some of their opportunities. Armia looking to go top shelf. But Athanasiou comes back and he lifts the stick and just turns what he wants. Doesn't get it into the hands. Doesn't draw the penalty. Transition for the Hawks.
Murphy banked one off the back wall. Domi just couldn't squeeze it past Montembeau on the rebound.
Well, if you don't have an opportunity and you get somebody in the shooting lane.
to the Montreal Canadiens. Max obviously going to Columbus at the time, and a couple of stops later, Max Domi has endeared himself here in Chicago to the fans, and Josh Anderson continues on for the Montreal Canadiens.
Murphy on the puck. Matheson tries to return the favor. Yolar Mia behind the net in front. Saves Soderblom on a point-blank blast from Josh Anderson.
It's a one-on-one battle in the corner. Matheson gets the stick in between the legs of Connor Murphy. He goes down. Should have been a penalty against Montreal.
And tapped by Dickinson away from Edmondson. Dickinson wraparound. Kara on the doorstep. Dickinson with a whack. And Kara again gets in the way. Dickinson. Caleb Jones scores! That third line for the Hawks just wouldn't give up the puck.
This is a great forechecking shift by this line. Dickinson, he's not going to be denied. He keeps working, throws it out in front of the net. All kinds of chaos. Gallagher has an opportunity to get it up, and he coughs it up again the second time on the shift. That great vision to see Caleb Jones sneaking down the back door. Nobody from Montreal, because of their structure, was broken down.
On the power play unit for Montreal, their first of the day. Monahan back to Matheson. Suzuki fires, scores. Just like that, Montreal's got the lead again. 21 seconds into the power play.
Coming from Suzuki, you heard it ring off the near post. Soderblom looks like he's in pretty good position, but this is just a perfect shot right underneath the crossbar. Suzuki picks up his 12th of the season.
And Monahan at 7:22.
Up to Monahan. Monahan, Armia in and out. Oh, that was close. It was off the post.
A quick 3-on-2 that comes into the zone. Center lane drive. Caleb Jones has to turn. Respect Josh Anderson heading to the net. That opens up Armia in behind and brings this one off.
Anthony Seu knocked away by Montembeau. 8 seconds left on the power play. Rister in front. Kara tried to knock it free. Anthony Seu's second try. Save Montembeau. Caleb Jones. One-timer Seth Jones. It's squibbed away. Kara in front with Anthony Seu. Back of the net. 5-on-5 hockey once again. Anthony Seu cuts in front. Save Montembeau. A beauty. Looking for Taves or perhaps McCabe, but Montreal's got it. Dadonov beats Gallagher. Gallagher walks in. Missed the backhand. Puck still free on the side of the cage.
He just misses on the backhand.
Keeps it a one-goal game. Montembeau, 26 years old. He was picked up off waivers as Monahan is denied off the post. After two.
Kurashev on the board. Nice job just tying him up, and then Monahan walks in from behind, and he's all alone. Beats him.
Chris Foster's Troy Murray, Colby Cohen between the benches. Still with us, Colby?
I am still with you,
all right,
Chris.
Good.
Just enjoying listening to you two up in the booth.
Matheson, Evans, onto the wing. Shot off the post. That was a ringer from Pezzetta. Jack Eye, Kovacevic, Suzuki for Doc. Doc backhand knocked down by Soderblom. Radish down low. Tate shoots. Radish just couldn't quite get the knockdown. Radish plays it up to Kane. Back to Radish. Radish scores! Hawks finally break through. A power play goal, and it's tied.
About getting the shot through. Doesn't necessarily have to be hard, but you look at Kane. He's got the shooting lane. Let's take it. Great little redirect to begin with by Radish, and then he picks up the loose puck to the right side of the goaltender and bats this one in. Hawks get a power play goal This game is tied at two. Great net front presence. Good job by Patrick Kane to recognize that that shooting lane was open.
He needs those two players on that last Blackhawks goal, and it certainly worked out for the best.
As greasy as Thanksgiving leftovers. No one else did for a beat or two. Look out! Athanasiou shoots behind the net. Domi.
Athanasiou goes in.
Suzuki past Monahan. Time for a post-Thanksgiving shootout. Oh, captain, my captain. Jonathan Toews on Sam Montembeau. Scores!
You don't see Toews do this very often. This is kind of a playbook that Patrick Kane uses.
Even at one, second round led by Patrick Kane. Off the side of the net.
Not a lot down low.
He had it. The move was there. Here's Andreas Athanasiou. Athanasiou serpentine scores!
Boo! Kirby Doc's going to get this opportunity. He scores. Montreal wins.
Doc, to defeat his former team, scores!
Yeah, look at him. Good for Kirby Doc. Tough for Soderblom. No saves in the shootout for the Hawks goaltender.
His previous team, Kirby Doc, with the game-winning shootout goal. Hawks get a point, but Montreal wins the game.
To wear them down, and hopefully as the game rolls on, you get more and more opportunities.
Zuccarello fires. That was blocked. Got a rebound chance. Saved by Murray. Rebound picked up by Simmons. Erickson Ek will draw for Minnesota against Tavares. Leaves control. Liljegren with it. Gives to Marner. Marner shot the score. Looked like it was tipped in the high slot. And Toronto's on the board first, less than 4 minutes in.
Wild get the puck out here to the point, and Marner just with a wrist shot in on the net, and all kinds of layers of screen there between Goligoski and Dumba. Fleury trying to look over top of the traffic, does not pick the puck up at all, and it goes in right over top of his shoulder, and the Toronto Maple Leafs strike first.
Goligoski hustles over to hold at the line. Kaprizov wins a puck battle, got it to Zuccarello. Zuccarello fires, saved by Murray. Rebound, Dumba shot, and that one deflected wide. Nylander across for Matthews. Tavares moving in, left alone. As he gets the shot away, Fleury slides across and makes the pad save.
Set plays go out of the playbook, and you just got to move the puck around as best you can and get your chances that way.
Addison holds. Kaprizov moves in. Hands it off to Boldy. Now back to Addison. Behind the back for Zuccarello. Cross ice Kaprizov. Up for Erickson. Kaprizov scores!
Around in the offensive zone, Kaprizov kind of jams Joel Eriksson Ek, and he just kicks it back to Kaprizov. Anytime pucks go through the seam, you're usually going to find yourself in trouble, and Matt Murray was scrambling all over the place. Kicks the puck back over to Joel Eriksson Ek, and he just deposits.
Camp pushes it ahead for Aston Reese. He'll let you know when he's tired.
No, he won't.
Oh, they score. Aston Reese throws it toward the net, and it trickles through Fleury. A quick answer for Toronto on one Fleury'd like to have back. It's 2-1 Maple Leafs.
Get the puck through the neutral zone with a lot of low-risk plays. Here, Kirill Kaprizov with a good defensive play, but then turns it over down there in the corner, and then just a short little wrist shot to the net, and Fleury, that looks to me like it went off the post and then off of his far.
Erickson Ek in the corner. Around behind for Zuccarello. Back to Kaprizov. A wraparound try saved by Murray. Rebound is finally covered by the Toronto goaltender.
They just keep their game simple, and they just continue to wear you down. Kirill Kaprizov and his line starting right now. They were the best line in the first period, and see if they can get off to a good start here.
Boldy for Gaudreau, and now Greenway carries to center. Greenway finds Goligoski, centers, Boldy scores! What a play, and the Wild have tied it!
On the far side of the ice, great defensive play, defense creates offense, Jordan Greenway finding some ice in the middle of the ice, and Goligoski with a nice saucer pass all the way across the ice, and that is a very difficult puck to one time as hard as he did that laid nice and flat, and he was able to slip that one right underneath the glove. The winger for Tavares and Marner tonight, Yarncroft getting an opportunity, Nick Robertson a few games ago.
Goligoski and Yarncroft after it there, Dumba up the wall, Greenway couldn't get it past Tavares. Now across, Giordano moving in. Loose puck and they score. Yarncroke had 24 square feet at which to shoot. And he buries it for a 3-2 Toronto lead.
Had to jump over. Boldy had to respect that. Freddie Gaudreau could not get back into the play. And then Yarncroft just comes up with a loose puck there. And Matt Dumba was unable to get over top of his stick. And he just throws that one in the empty net. Very fortunate for the Leafs that one.
Zuccarello knocked it away from Sandin. Steele pounces on it. Back to Spurgeon. Spurgeon fires. That was blocked. Steele on the rebound. Tried to tuck it in. Then instead tried to feed Zuccarello. Giordano holds his own. And it skips away. Dewar shorthanded for Minnesota. Dewar on the breakaway. Saved by Murray.
Don't be surprised if that man right there gets a few extra shifts on the fourth line here. And as we've talked about a lot, he's got the ability to raise his game even in the third period.
Eriksson Ek. On the draw for Minnesota, Kaprizov fires and a save by Murray.
Again, just jumping through as a left-handed shot there. Oh, he took a stick. See where this stick, inadvertent.
Fleury leaves it for Addison. A lot going on here, just opening seconds of the power play. Eriksson Ek in, saved by Murray.
Addison, with his head up all the time, finds Ek. Didn't have quite as much speed as he would have liked there.
Kaprizov to Steele. Steele tried to go back to the line. Aston Reese knocks it away. Short-handed Aston Reese. Saved by Fleury.
Some great players out there in Calgary during some of those years.
Greenway with a little mix-up with Spurgeon. It results in a chance for Engvall. And a glove saved by Fleury. 3-on-3 at the Leafs line. It deflects back to Merrill. And now Kaprizov with it. Kaprizov to Zuccarello, and a save by Murray.
The offensive zone has the puck, is able to turn a no-look pass, and Zuccarello gets all. The Wild defensemen in the offensive zone are having a difficult time.
Nylander scores! Beats Fleury from the high slot, and Toronto extends the lead to 2 goals.
He ain't looking to pass. He's looking to shoot, and he comes up with a loose puck here off of the cycle. Nice little pass there. Is able to beat Marc-Andre Fleury right underneath the blocker. Great shot from a great goal scorer. And the Toronto Maple Leafs have doubled their lead.
For Minnesota, 6-on-5 for the Wild. Zuccarello goes across. Kaprizov denied by Murray.
No question, the one.
Well, he's the only one who made contact with the net.
Yeah, I mean.
Faceoff back into the corner. Boldy lost his stick. He's back on it now. Eriksson Ek has it in the corner. To the line, Goligoski. Kaprizov fires. Zuccarello scores!
the Wild had all of last season and finally get a puck on net and catch a little bit of a break. That rebound off of Murray's pad right onto Zuccarello's stick, and he makes no mistake and buries that one into the empty net. Marc-Andre Fleury back between the pipes for the Wild.
Forced it back into Toronto ice. Sandin is there for the Leafs. Off the wall. Kaprizov centers! And a sliding save by Murray! And put it right on the tape for Kaprizov. Murray slides across and makes one of the biggest saves of the night.
And this is what he's been doing for the Toronto Maple Leafs after he's come back from his injury. It was the reason that they ended the New Jersey Devils 13-game streak, and when they needed him the most with 3 seconds left. How did that puck stay out? Kirill Kaprizov was absolutely exhausted, had been on the ice for the full 2 minutes, got a lot of wood on it. I don't know if Murray got over there, Anthony, or not, but no idea how that puck stayed out of the net, and neither does Kirill Kaprizov.
To the corner. And a quick shot turned away by Stolarz as they work it down low. Getting the opportunity was Matthew Joseph.
Real nice year again for the Ducks. Gets down early. See how he was down on his knees before that.
Enstrom gets enough of it to get it across the zone. Goes Giroux, moves it around the boards. It escapes the stick of Stützle in the corner, but comes back to him up the right side. He sends it across and off the skate. Terry sends it ahead. Nice catch of the pass by Henrik. He's turned away by Talbot.
With a real nice play at the opposite end, Adam Henrik gets this. He's running out of racetrack here. He just tries to sneak it five hole, but you could see he was being stick checked. Thompson on the backside.
He's positioned out high as Batherson handles it in the right corner. Kachuk muscles it back, and now the Senators set up with the extra man. Here's DeBrincat, quickly moves it over. Shabbat right on the goal mouth, and they get it to Kachuk in front. He scores. Boy, that was nice execution by the Ottawa power play. They moved it around and they got the look they wanted.
Watch as he shifts over to the opposite side. Batherson slides down low, and now the only guy that can prevent that pass getting through to Kachuk is Simon Benoit. And Batherson set a little bit of a pick on him there that delayed him getting across.
Cam riding a 5-game scoring streak coming into today. That equals his career high. Now Zegras trying to feed it in on the backhand, and that's intercepted. And Tyler Mott leads it the other way. The trailer is Joseph wide open. It's a goal for Derek Brassard. 2-0 Ottawa, and Brassard continues to love seeing the Ducks.
It's constant for him, his production against the Ducks. Rush up the ice, it's a 3-on-2 rush, and then it turns in with the boy, you know what, that's bad back checking by the Ducks. It's the fourth man into the zone, and look at the gap between him and the two back checkers.
But Isaac follows up. They move it around the boards. Shattenkirk shot. Oh, wow, and there's a spinning rebound chance for Regenda. Oh, Talbot is down and out. And
somehow managed to keep that puck out. Contact with Talbot. Boy, the Ducks had a wide open net. Didn't realize that they had that much time, I think. And one save made by Travis Hammond.
So fresh ice and nearly a full 2-minute compliment. A minute 55 remaining in the penalty to Travis Hamonic as we begin the second period. Fowler to the middle, across Zegras, dusts it off behind the back. Fowler one time, blast! Talbot made the save, didn't corral it. Oh, the rebound! That may have gone right through him and off the goal post.
With the man advantage, pass from Zegras. There's the blocker save by Talbot, and watch the spinorama right there, and it's off the...
Pops into the middle, and Tavish with a hard pass, went off Leeson's stick in behind it, and he recovers it. Jones changes direction, brings it right in front, backhand bit, and the paddle of the stick for Talbot kept that out.
Corey Terry unable to cash in that rebound, and Max...
Sends moving around to the near circle off the crossbar. Stützle, boy, he got everything he wanted on that one-timer.
It's that left goalpost. Oh, excuse me, the crossbar.
Great puck recoveries by the Senators power play unit as Ottawa controls it. Batherson hands it off to Stützle. Native of Germany draws two defenders right on the doorstep, trying to jam it in with Kachuk.
And Sanderson team up the rim and around two on one. Here's Tkachuk, partial break. Tkachuk takes the shot and got his own rebound and put it right back into Stolarz.
I thought that the passing lane was taken away by Cam Fowler again, who hits the deck and essentially says, I'm not going to let you pass. I'm not expecting that to happen.
No? The only thing constant is change. That's all I know.
Third power play of the afternoon for the Senators. They're 1-for-2. Batherson carries it in, and Stützle fires it home.
Boy, he's got a release, doesn't he? I mean, this has always been the book on Tim Stützle. Gain the zone, and just a couple of passes into the middle, and Stützle's shot. I don't know if Anthony Stolarz was able to pick up the release. Benoit went out to challenge. It's a perfect shot. And doing a pretty good job overall of tying up those sticks in front.
Beaulieu off the window all the way down. No icing as Anaheim gets changes and Jones couldn't get to it. Lead pass to Tyler Mott. Former All-American out of Michigan gets it right into the goal crease. Knocked away by Stolarz, but it comes back to Zub and he scores. Artem Zub picks the top corner. It's 4-0.
Doesn't get any help from his defenders. Nobody clears it out of harm's way. It's just tap back to Zub, and he just throws it up into the top corner with all kinds of traffic in front. See, Stolarz is down. Remember what I said about where most goals are scored these days. And Zub does a good job of, you know, getting those hands high on the follow-through.
Carries the offensive load, but as you pointed out, Brian, he's been out of the lineup of late. Here's Shabbat right down the slot, hands it off, and DeBrincat's shot off the shoulder of Stolarz. And Giroux wins the draw. Sanderson, top of the zone. Broussard right on the doorstep and turned away was Tkachuk.
As we've seen on the two power play goals for the Senators, they do like to work the puck down low.
Zegras joins McTavish and Strome in the box as he serves the initial penalty. Interesting situation. He signed last year as a free agent with the Minnesota Wild, a 3-year deal. And then, of course, the Wild acquired Marc-Andre Fleury. And they made some changes. What a save by Stolarz. Delayed penalty coming up for the Ducks.
Sells that a little bit. Here was the stop made moments earlier by Stolarz as he was able to get that right pad down.
On Simon Benoit early in the game that the Ducks took exception to might be part of the reason that Sam Carrick chased him across the zone to give him that short little cross check. Meantime, Broussard across the line with Pinto. Room in the middle of the ice for Joseph. Broussard got it back to him, and he scored. As he was falling, fighting through a stick check, Matthew Joseph makes it 5-0.
And you're in a pretty weak position. It's tough to get your balance back. So watch what Stolarz does. He goes and misses on the swipe, and now he's kind of deep in the net. He can't get back to his feet. And as a result, it's just kind of a little chip shot that goes over the left arm. You know, just, as you mentioned, 10 different teams for Broussard in his career. 35 now. He's a high pick, sixth overall.
Oh, nice pad save. Flashing the left leg out was Talbot that time. Zegras curls off the wall, brings it into the middle. Great pass to McTavish. Hit the goal post.
Oh, boy. That was just a great play by Trevor Zegras as he...
The puck, then Jones took it back. Rushed back to the line. And Colton White with a lot of room coming in off the right side. His pass goes through. It's underneath Talbot. In the blue, they score! Talbot was just trying to lay on top of the puck. And I believe it was Max Jones jammed it home.
The style of game that Ellis Akins is looking for. You're right. It's just Jones just hacking away at it. Loose puck. And they win a puck back. You see that puck was rattling around between the leg pads of the goaltender Talbot. And Jones just kept carving it. He carved that one right into the back of the net.
Second of the season for Max, who now has points in consecutive.
So here's the initial shot by White. The puck gets in behind Talbot. Once that puck is in the crease, you're allowed to go in after it. I don't see anything wrong with that goal. I think Ottawa's going to get shorthanded.
Notice I haven't hedged one way or the other, as we'll get the word.
After further review, the call on the ice is confirmed. We have a good goal.
And now it's an Ottawa power play as Tkachuk steps out of the box. And he's behind the defense. He'll take an area pass off the wall and cut in off right wing. Stolarz makes the save on the first bid and on the rebound. Yeah. He's having an ongoing conversation with Benoit as the playback at the other end to Brinkett steps between the two of them. In the meantime, the clock expires.
The Flyers trying to snap an eight-game skid as Hayes steals this puck away. Looks for a one-timer, and Jari, the first test, is a good one as Noah Cates denied. And then the puck back on net, and it's turned aside. And a sharp angle shot to the net. That's protected by Pettersson as the Flyers have come out on the opening shift, charging at the Penguin net. That pass stolen away at the line by Morgan Frost. And then this one is headmanned on to Kiefer Bellows. Trying to drag his way through. He was harassed from behind by Joseph. This one bangs off the outside of the goal. Thought it was covered by Jari. Eventually, the whistles come. That was by Jackson Cates. We've got the two Cates brothers in the game. Jackson and Noah Cates both playing for the Philadelphia Flyers tonight.
Only 16 months apart.
That shot got through from Letang, and that's the first shot of the game for Pittsburgh.
You show a little bit more gumption, as we say.
Well, then Tortorella said, right, we're talking before the game, right? You got to find him. You want to see him all the time on the ice and be involved.
This one came to the front, and Carter Hart makes a glove save on Jeff Carter.
How they coach the game, how they develop players.
Here's a chance right in front for Rust, and a glove save from Hart.
Beforehand, they open up the doors at 1 o'clock. Gave out some t-shirts as well, as they're going to be celebrating the 2026 World Cup here in Philly.
Here's Crosby out to the line for Pettersson. Move to Letang right side. Letang's shot blocked on the way. Malkin angles it out. Joseph tried to go to the net. It was blocked away. Scooped up by Zucker. Touchdown high. Joseph again. Now Petrie. Petrie snaps one. Blocker save. And the rebound all the way to the wall. Finally sends it to Letang. Now the pass to Pettersson. Drifting. Shooting. Tip. Knocked down. Turning. Paling with a shot. Save hard. Sanheim with a rebound. He'll just throw it down the ice. Just outside the crease by Braun.
Yeah, he was trying to play that off to the side, not directly at the goaltender. I think he was trying to hit Raquel. Worst case scenario, hit him in the pants and get a redirection from the side.
McKeown trying to go coast to coast, and it's kicked out by Jari. McKeown, three goals this year. Looked like a superstar on this play, but a nice stop by Tristan Jari. Rust got back to it. Ristolainen trying to shoot it down. It came right to the stick of Rust. He's ahead with speed. Rust to the slot with a wrist shot, guided away by Hart.
Even tonight, you see Crosby, offensive zone, doing simple things, shoulder checks, puck protection, the simple things, and continues to be so effective.
Turnover, here's Bluger walking in with a shot, save, rebound, scores! Josh Archibald was there to clean up the rebound, and the Pittsburgh Penguins take a 1-0 lead.
And he decides to go back to the Archibald line that had a real good shift prior to that, and you can see that's a fumbled on puck there by Braun. It doesn't lay flat for him, and that's the result, and that's a goal against. If that's a flat puck and Braun gets it out, you don't see this situation. Good save on the first one. No one picks up their man, and Archibald, who was very aggressive and very tenacious in their last game against the Calgary Flames, gets on the board here with our AT&T 5G.
A nice description that Sullivan used where the team is playing conscientious, right, to be aware.
Brutal shot turned away. And Heinen trying to center, ramped off the stick of Hart. Still the help game from Malkin. Crosby on the near wing. Petrie moves it. Letang thought about it, puts it down, takes a few steps in front, tapped around. Malkin keeps it alive. Scott Walker, Cam Atkinson, Wade Allison, Tanner Hansdyke. Yeah, yeah. One shot wide. Sean Couturier.
Even did you mention Allison?
Not yet. That was the last guy on my list.
It's funny, huh? Make a big trade like that and hardly seen him.
This shot off the shoulder of Carter Hart. Down to 35 seconds to go in the period. Letang, left side, Pettersson winds up. Slot pass, score! Sidney Crosby, a beautiful deflection in the high slot. And in the closing seconds of the period, the Penguins take a 2-0 lead.
Tell you what, Pettersson's had a heck of a game. And maybe he's doing this in the spirit of the late, great Boreas Salt. It's a set play. You'll see from the left side of your screen where Crosby's going to come in right there. And with that small blade of Crosby's and that straight stick of his, no curve hardly at all, he gets it right on the heel. And that is a brilliant redirection right there.
But look, Pettersson, heads up. He knows exactly where he's putting that one. Crosby, the little speech. You talked about some of the difficulty, even for you, to find the right words to describe big, special moments for these players in the league. How is
Penguins working around the offensive zone? And it's handled here at the top. Long range shot. Tip score.
What a shot by Bluger to get that through.
Ryan Poehling with the deflection, and the Penguins with a 3-0 lead.
I tell you what, that first layer from the Philadelphia Flyers are not blocking these shots. Through the point, and watch Poehling. A great redirection right there. It's one thing for those long shots to get through and a goalie can see them and make the stop. It's another thing when they're going like this and they entirely change directions, as you're already set for the original play. With all the skill that's out of their lineup, this is going to have to be a real grind here to get back in the game. It's got to be more meat and potatoes.
Malkin with a shot, that one right on, and absorbed and held by Carter Hart, who has seen plenty of shots. Theo Joseph to Letang down low. Sharp angled shot turned away by Hart. And now Joseph to come get it.
Hey, by the time we get to Fenway on January the 2nd here on TNT, it'll get there. Todd Reardon's got the edge right now. Mike Vellucci.
This one goes in from behind the net. It's Poehling's second.
It's a jam play. Around a couple of scraps, haven't changed it, and now here's the goal. Keep your eye on Hart here on this side. It goes off the heel of his stick and then ricochets back between his pads. It's there. Yes, it does, right off the blade. The blade there is a little late getting to you, and yeah, try to give it right back to him. Malkin wasn't ready for that return pass.
Malkin was ready for that. A couple of jams on net, and the first test for Felix Sandstrom. One airborne, Raquel after it, stopped Braun from clearing it in front for Crosby alone, and it just rolled off his stick and wide. Sandstrom stayed with him. There wasn't much to shoot at, even if it stayed on his stick. Crosby already a goal in the game. Not here though. Still 4-0 Pittsburgh. Dumoulin for Joseph. Slid down to Gensel. Gensel for Raquel off Sandstrom.
And Raquel, and then you've got the Malkin line. They get enough candy on the ozone faceoff, but these guys are doing a lot of the grunt work for the Penguins.
And the reality is the Penguins are the oldest team in the league.
They learned how to skate as kids.
Yes, they did.
Their edge work is terrific.
Here's a chance working in McEwen, and a penalty called here.
Shot.
It's possible. Farabee almost banked it in from the corner.
Has been awarded a penalty shot for being fouled from behind.
There.
Okay.
And he doesn't get a shot.
In the second? Big chance for him now.
You're going high glove or deep to the back end, Jennifer?
Deep to the back
end. Okay.
12th penalty shot in the NHL so far this season. Zach McEwen and Tristan Jarry. And Jarry makes the save.
Oh, that was not the look I was thinking right there. And he knows it too.
9-1 now, 10-1. In the third period. This one deflected to the front and a chance for Farabee. And he couldn't connect. It was also odd to see 18 skaters flat on their back, waving their legs in the air as they mimicked his warm-up.
Oh, that was classic.
Here's Hayes trying to get in. He found the puck, and he scores! A nice job by Kevin Hayes. He worked his way in and puts the Flyers on the board here in the third.
More pucks towards the goaltender, and Tristan Jarry's played really, really well. And maybe a little false sense of security, trailing by four. The push on for the Flyers, they're probably thinking we needed this push a little bit earlier, but they've still given the fans some hope that have stayed in the building, which plenty of them have. And look at this play, trying to play it. At first, I think, Jennifer, looking to stick blade changed a little bit all along him, knowing he's going to go short side, and he does so. Maybe trick the eyes of the goaltender a little bit.
Yeah, dances around Petrie there.
Bluger on the response and a save from Sandstrom. Morgan Frost for Tippett, return to Frost, the backhand block, Tippett off the iron. Little toe drag and a quick snap hit the outside of the post. Final seconds winding off the clock here in Philadelphia.
They're telling him to stay on the ice.
He's run out of time. The Pittsburgh Penguins win their fifth in a row and they're headed home.
Wallman's got it now. He finds Raymond, who finds Osterley, the former Arizona Coyote. Wide open. Raymond's thought. Oh! It looked like it hit the back of the net. They say no.
Just on the wrong side there.
Shot tipped. Oh, good save. All redirected. And Husso was quick with the right pad to stop that.
Bottom line is the way you play the game and how you feel when it's over and how you contribute it.
Schmaltz with a shot.
None of being contributed.
Sherratt. Bertuzzi to Hronek. Chop up quick, they score!
Oh, wow, wow. Guess who? The guy we were just talking about. It looks like Kopp's going to get the goal. Yep. Good quick jump on a loose puck right there. The goaltender didn't even have a chance to get back up. And that's the first goal of this game. Second of the year for Andrew Kopp.
Mata swings one back for Hronek. He's also got a three-game goal streak on the line and 9 points.
Look at this.
The past six. Here's Foligno. For Suter. Oh, big save, Amelka. Brought back by Hayton. Got dumped at the line. Larkin's got it. Larkin into the Coyote zone. Larkin cut back. And the save made by Vamalka.
Hockey fights cancer for a lot of years now. Started around the NHL. Quite a movement.
And raising millions of dollars in 2017, but ended 26 points behind the second wildcard spot. Wraparound try there that Fussell hangs on to. Bertuzzi nudged it back. Bergeron across. Running. Scores!
Wow.
Is he ever hot? A four-game goal streak and 10 points the past six.
And it wasn't exactly a bomb either. Wow. It was a funny looking shot. It really wasn't in his wheelhouse. He didn't get everything on it, and you can hear the clank of that goalpost to the left of the goalie. Late in the power play to make it 2-0 Detroit. Shoot first, Phillip, and boy, is it paying off.
And he better not shave that mustache.
Really?
In front of the goal! Perron clearing it ahead. Goss is fair for Boyd. Travis Boyd shoots it in. Sider. Chychrun able to keep it in. They score!
Deflection.
Right tipped in front of the goal by Nick Schmaltz, who had injured ribs in the season opener. He only returned last Monday. He'd missed 15 games of this night.
Well, he was second in scoring on this team last year. There's the fortunate bounce off the shaft of the stick on a play that came out of nowhere, and you got a one-shot game.
Here's a chance in front, and Bertuzzi played it back, but Pop couldn't get there. Osterley scores against his former team, makes it 3-1.
And again, Detroit defenseman absolutely on a roll. Two more goals tonight. Looks like the goaltender never saw the shot. People crossing in front. His own player crossed right in front of him.
Drop back for Dylan Larkin. The team leader in points. Six the past three. Right in! And a save made. Now in Plymouth, formerly in Ann Arbor. Bergeron with a flipper, the cop. Finds Raymond down low, Bertuzzi. Shot, save made. As Schmaltz up high, watched by Valina.
Look at this, reeling the guy without the puck. Look out.
Keller across the top, they score!
Wow.
Set up for J.J. Moser. Okay. The Swiss native with his second goal.
Finally, somebody missed an assignment. And they're wide open. Boom. Now, I don't know if you call that missed an assignment or not. Top of the circle, 35 feet. Shot may have hit Sider and went by the goaltender, not sure.
Getting it back from Boleno. Then Bergeron gets knocked down. Good hit put on him by Fisher. Boleno just missed it in front. Larkin, perfectly, angled back. Here's Wallman in front, a good stop made.
Wow.
The Hockey Fights Cancer hat on. And we're underway now for the third period.
They're creating a lot of opportunities, even though the shots don't indicate it. They know how to move the puck around. Boy, boy.
Cleared away by Hronek. And he came up with it for Sherratt. Save made off a one-timer from Kubalik. Kubalik hit Nemeth, came up with the puck to Larkin. Oh, and another stop by Vemelka. He's been really good. Popped up in front. Bertuzzi all alone. Oh, and he walked it right back into Vemelka. Round for Clayton Keller. Penalty over Bertuzzi out of the box. Chychrun a shot. Stop. Oh. Rebound. They couldn't throw it in. Chychrun a shot. He scores.
Wow. Good goal. Yes, it did. It's either Sider in front of the net. Body's all over. How they didn't score on that one. They missed that. Ritchie. Or make that Schmaltz. He's already got a goal tonight. And I believe it went off of Sider's right foot.
Yeah. So overtime underway. Sherratt, Raymond, and Larkin. Keller, Hayton, Gostis, spare for Arizona. Dylan Larkin. Circles the net, wraparound try. Raymond plays it back, Sherratt. And deflected out of play. And it goes for Jack McBain, who drops back for Christian Fischer. Overskated, has it again. Save made by Husso. Around from McBain to Fischer.
To go for Chychrun.
Chychrun's in. Chychrun's got it. Fire save by Husso. Long pass for Bertuzzi. Trying to catch the Coyotes in a change. Drops it back. Larkin save made by Vilmaka. Shot off to the corner. Perron has to hurry.
Oh my, what a save that was.
As time expires. Oh.
Scares the heck out of me, boy.
Tied with Crosby and McDavid for most road points at 16. Saved by Husso.
Wow. And guess who?
9 shots through overtime for Dylan. Will this one be the winner? Yes!
Bingo!
Stretch their winning streak to 4.
What a party. Holy mackerel.
Let's go to John Keating and Jimmy Howard for Red Wings Live.
Up the left wing wall. Here's Goodrow. Long stretch pass. Rossell making the clear. Shoots and denied. Sorokin right there to make the stick save. And how about the heads up play there by Goodrow to spring Roslovic in alone.
Take a look at that pass there by Goodrow, and he finds a flying Jack Roslovic who's stretching the defense, and perfect shot down low, and Sorokin with nice stick slash blocker and pad save there.
Barzal behind the back pass to himself. Right there is Nyquist defending. Jacket send it up but not out. Now Nelson right circle looking for the rebound. Was Lee who tried to shovel it home, but Korpisalo, who looked behind him, had it in the blue paint and covered up.
By Korpisalo closing the legs here. See Nelson's gonna put it in front and then right here. Oh, nice save by Nyquist. Couldn't see it from ice level, but that was close. You can see it right here. He knows he's going 5-0 and Gus.
York. Backing up here is an odd man rush. Look at Carson Meyer come back. They negate the odd man rush, and there's a shot and a goal by Wahlstrom over the glove of Jonas Korpisalo. And on the rush, the Islanders have the first goal of the game.
But he's going to come. Here's the exit there by the Islanders. And that puck's going to go from left to right, and there he is. He cuts through, and yes, used Gudbranson as a screen. and perfect timing on the release there. Beats Korpisalo on the glove side. So, yeah, it's been a low-scoring chance affair here for the Blue Jackets. Different look there for Blue Jackets, try to create some shots from the point, and then traffic in front with defensemen. They did it two or three times, so let's see where that leads.
That was our nationwide telestrator as Korpisalo makes a point-blank save. And coming off a game in which they picked up another shorthanded tally. A centering pass, bounces, Robinson trying to corral it, and he's going to get a penalty here now as he attempted to play it along the right wing with Wahlstrom.
Columbus Valley number 50, 2 minutes
as we go to break. A save in the dying seconds of the power play by Sorokin, and now Robinson. Nelson coming off a two-goal performance against the Blue Jackets in the previous meeting. Pageau, Barzell looks for the point, gets it right back from Dobson. Oh, nice move.
Solid, that pass got to go from Barzell right across the crease.
On for Nelson. Saucers a backhand pass. Dobson, Barzell. Barzell, Dobson, shot wide off the back wall and into the net. It's a power play goal. And the red-hot Pageau, who had two goals the previous game, since Pageau was put back on that top power play unit.
Yeah, and that power play is hot, and Jean-Gabriel Pageau there, he gets a perfect rebound off the backboard right here, and he's right behind the left of Korpisalo. No chance for Korpi or for Gudbranson. And sometimes these are set play, but here I think the defenseman simply...
Barzell and Dobson pick up the assists. In front, down is Sorokin, bouncing puck, and somehow, some way, he's able to come up with it and gets the whistle. We go to break once more. Jenner on the doorstep, and there, can't lift it over the pad of Sorokin. Beauvillier tried to feed the slot there for Wahlstrom. Jackets break it up, and Gavrikov shorthanded, walking into the zone, fights off Beauvillier. Oh, what a great individual effort, and Sorokin got just enough to steer it aside. Chinnikov hanging out of that puck, right point. Jenner standing in front of Sorokin. Here's Chinnikov, scores! Power play goal, what a shot, and what a goal. The Jackets have cut the deficit and still will be on the power play.
And the Blue Jackets go with five forwards on the five-on-three here. It's going to go from Gaudreau to Chinnikov for running the point. And here's the pass right here. It is not a one-timer. Perfect screen by Boone Jenner. He beats Sorokin on the glove side. So now they got to go to a more typical power play with York and Gaudreau at the point. But that was interesting to see.
Jackets control, looking down low, and kept away from Kent Johnson, who was capped in the near circle. Gaudreau, York, Johnson, lets one fly, scores! Power play goal, his second, and the Jackets have tied it up! Two power play goals on a 5-on-3, they cash in on both, it's tied at two!
Well, what a shot there by Kent Johnson. He goes glove side again on Sorokin. And yes, Kent Johnson going to shoot the puck very often, but here he picks a spot, lets it go, and of course, Boone Jenner.
Here we go. Pageau wins the draw. We are underway, and the puck rifled into the Columbus end. Left wing pass at center. Bounced behind the New York net. Dobson try to protect that puck away from Gaudreau, who comes up with it. A centering feed sent wide by Nyquist. A second attempt by Nyquist. That one was blocked.
But let's take a look here early in the period. It's Johnny Gaudreau, who's got two assists tonight. You just mentioned a nice clean pass to Gus Nyquist. And then Boone goes right back to Gus. And this one, unfortunately. Oh, nice save by Sorokin.
Pellick away from Gaudreau. Pellick circles the net. Drops it into the slot. Parise denied. And Korpisalo covers up on the rebound.
The law firm here, well, he finds Zach Parise, and he's going to get two shots at it. Good job by Korpisalo to keep that rebound.
He has two goals, three assists, 5 points in the last six games. And you could just see the confidence growing. Missed a couple of games with a minor hand injury. but back in the lineup tonight. And certainly making his presence felt. Puck turned over. Brock Nelson off the wall, moves in and scores. Brock Nelson, who had two in the previous meeting, puts the Islanders back in front.
Boy, here's the bounce here. Christensen's trying to get it past Nelson. He hugs that board and he goes short side. Not much room there. Beats Korpisalo on the glove side. And yeah, that's an elite play right there by Brock Nelson.
10th goal of the season to lead the Islanders in that regard, coming off a career year. Bjork, heel to the left wing, shot by Chinnikov, in front, Gaudreau! How did that stay out of the net? The Islanders are able to block it, the Jackets claim the puck is in the net.
And they're trying to hit Chinnikov, and he's going to get a laser, get right through traffic, and here's a rebound for Johnny Gaudreau, and that's your Nissan move of the game right here. The save by Ilya Sorokin. Stretches himself across the left side to rob Johnny Gaudreau.
Discussion continues with referee Kelly Sutherland. Blue Jackets want an explanation. Replay being shown here now in the center ice video board. Picked up by Chinnikov. Bjork, left wing Gaudreau. Back for Bjork. Bjork, Chinnikov has it. Fires Sorokin right there with a glove save.
Cross again. Opens up that passing lane, and Chinnikov, not comfortable, he's going with the wrist shot. And
timeout being called here. Blue Jackets call the timeout. And they'll set up a play with a faceoff in New York territory. You just see the fans whipped around the wall. Cut off there. Gaudreau lets one fly. In front, Johnson. Bjork stepped up, tried to sweep it away. Jackets looking for one more chance here. Gaudreau held. And there's the horn, and Gaudreau can't believe it. He looks back at the referee. No call, and the Islanders hold on for a 3-2 victory.
We don't let them get the pucks in the net. We don't allow them shots.
Paulo Hughes and Mercer out there now. They work that puck down low. Anderson, couple of big stops. Right down on the doorstep. 86 carrying it over the line. Stuck for a moment, but now has the puck in behind the Buffalo net. Sends it out in front, and that one's run up the post. One-timer by Mercer.
Golden opportunity right here with a one-timer in the slot area. Fortunately, that goes off the post. And then
7 minutes gone here in the opening period. No score. Shot 6-1 in favor of the Devils. And in the Buffalo zone again. Working a 2-on-1 on the far side. And the shot stopped by Anderson. Oh, what a save on the rebound.
He gets an opportunity as well. Shots right now 8-1, Dan. And probably
Jurgensen's the rest of the way from the left wing. Fires it in behind the net. Schmidt plays it around Graves. This is a turnover. See what we do with it here. Dahlin with the dance, and he tried to finish it. Sends it back in front. Up high, holding it with a shot. It deflects just wide of the goal. Quinn.
Here he comes down to the wall. He just kind of curls and drags there. Tries to go backhand to forehand, going short side, not able to connect it. And watch, Samuelson back.
As Thompson gets to center, to the wing for Cousins. Double teamed on the wall. Siegenthaler getting some help. Sharon Govich. Sabres outnumber. Nice pass. Skinner with a shot. And the save is made. And a bouncing puck comes back to Skinner. Graves off the far wall. Hughes lost it. 2-on-1 chance for Buffalo. Gergensen's with Kyle Pozo. Gergensen carries and fires it off the boards. And it comes to the far side. The Devils will chip it up to center.
I mean, moving the puck. Not so much the feet. It's moving the puck quicker.
Already highlighting as well where you do not want to turn. You don't want to turn the puck over at all, obviously. Buffalo in their own end. Turn it over. Holla at center. Couldn't make the play up ice. Sabres come back. Cousins check from behind. And the Devils bring three. Now four in the zone. Here's a pass with Hughes. Puts one in the back of the net with a one-timer. And the Devils strike first.
Here's Dylan Cousins trying to get this one deep, and he loses it just inside the blue line. Quinn's the one that's going to pick it up and get this started going up the ice. And he's going to be the benefactor of that third pass coming down and just a quick one-timer going down on that knee with that quick shot.
And with some good numbers. Power starts it. Jones to the side of the net trying to bang it. And the whistle went before the Sabres celebrated what they think is a goal. But the referee was instantly waving that off. Samuelson down low to help out. He turns it over. Wood trying to steer that to the front of the net. Devils for Hamilton. Right side shot, tip right on, and Anderson ahead of the blue ice, able to come up with the save. Again with a cross ice pass, and Zetterlund will put it down towards the corner, picked up by Samuelson. He lost an edge, puck comes in front, Anderson, it goes up and over him and in the net. Jesper Boqvist with the puck that somehow finds a way over Anderson, and it's 2-0 New Jersey.
Samuelson right there, he wipes out. And that's where the puck gets turned over. And the quick pass of Oquist in the front. There, right there. Sterngovich, he's just on the backhand, finds him in front. And there's the quick shot by 70. You got two Sabres caught down low. That's Dylan Cousins, who is dropping down it.
Rebound all the way to the far side. Siegenthaler kept it in, but now open ice. Here's a pass ahead by Gergensen. Take to take. Jones with the shot. Rebound! After the first save by Schmid, Jones could not get the second chance. Shot stopped by Anderson again to the far post. And it's Victor Olsson who has to turn that puck quickly away from the pressure of the Devils. Jokke Harju ahead to Mittelstadt. Sabres with numbers if they push it. Mittelstadt slides it ahead. Olsson scores!
Talking about right here. Win a battle down low. Move this puck up. Nice job by Jokke Harju getting up to Casey Mittelstadt. And Casey waiting in the last second there. As soon as he crossed the line, he's looking. And he gets that pass perfectly across to Victor Olsson, who's coming right down the gut. You see him just kind of fake it a little bit, throws it across.
Sends it around to the point. This is Dahlin. Here come the Sabres fans. Thompson fires to the net. That is gloved down, but the rebound comes back up top. Thompson from Dahlin. Near point to the net with the shot, and that's steered away by Schmid. Mike Graves tips it down to the corner. All three Sabres on that line down in this corner. Now it's sent out to the far dot, and a save made by Schmid as he got over to that far post.
And he doesn't mind yelling down the bench to somebody to, you know, to do something differently. And that's what you want. That's leadership right there in a young man.
Devils bring three, and they're going to get in behind. First shot scores! Tatar with the finish.
He wants to challenge this one in any way, but nevertheless, if not Tatar, he's walking in. He's going to get his fifth. If they don't,
Nabushkin slides it through. This is Gergensen's behind the net to the far corner. Up top, Fitzgerald's one-timer. Knocked down. Cataposo trying to jam it in after Schmid did well to knock it down, but could not control the rebound. They've got 20 minutes to come out and prove that they can hang with the Devils' speed and tenacity. And it's up to the players at this point. They've seen it. Fitzgerald crossing the line. Sends that one to the dot. Sabres committing on this play. Now it's off the post and it comes right back out front. Sabres get it back again. 0-4 when he started his NHL career back in 21-22. Man in front, stopped by Anderson. That centering pass right to the front of the net. Jost down in the corner. Pass between the legs. Gergensen's racing down onto it. Jost right in front of the net. Loose puck. It's still free. In front of the goal. They bang off the post. Cataposo hit iron through that crowd. On the Rachel's Mediterranean Grill penalty kill. I love my Rachel's. You'll love your Rachel's too. Hughes slaps across ice. Bastion in front. Stopped by Anderson on the far post. Drop back and Hughes. We'll bring it in across the line. Heischer. Cross ice pass. Oh, my goodness. Anderson goes for a slide and a stop. And back the other way. Cousins to center.
Third period. Here's the two-pad stack we talk about on Anderson right here. He comes in. Miles Wood thinks he's got him. He's trying going upstairs. And Anderson.
Sabres' lone goal in this game. Off the stick of Victor Olofsson to this point. Here's Dahlin in front. What a move. Oh, and they keep it out.
spin somehow. Not sure how he did it.
To flick the puck up high underneath the bar. Watch as he tries to go up. That's good.
Cross ice pass by Mercer. Sabres able to break that up. Here's turnover right in front of the net. Oh, Anderson, when needed, makes a big glove save on Hughes. Puck bounces to the front of the net. It'll be kept in by Power, top of the zone. Power with a wrister towards the net. Rebound, Pozo shot is stopped by Schmid. Power up top, Thompson to the far circle. Near side, Olofsson holds it. Dahlin walks in, back to Olofsson! And that did not squeak through as Schmid got over and squeezed tightly. Up the middle, and a backhand pass. Quinn down the right side. Paterka behind the net, center in front. Oh, what a save. Rebound, Quinn trying to go high, and it's deflected up. Far corner, Holla racing over. Sealed on the boards by Dahlin. 1:38 to go. Power puts it to the net. Loose puck in front. Schmid is down. Doing the partial snow angel. Whistle is gone again. Picks it up with 6 seconds. Middlestat cross ice. Cousins with 3 seconds crossing the line, and that will do it. Devils hang on to win it 3-1.
This one's in the corner. Puck battle ensues. There's a quick shot, and Binnington called upon to make his first stop of the night. Stamkos centers it. That one got up high and clips Nick Paul. Another drive goes wide, and it's picked up by St. Louis. Kyrou up high on the zone, drops it out for Letty. Letty leaves it for Kyrou. He'll cut it in the middle. There's a shot and a save made by Vasilevsky. And if you got that blocker on that, Jordan Kyrou had a breakout season last year. Cal Foote back in the lineup. He's missed the last 5 games. Number 52 for the Lightning. He was injured in a game against Washington on November 11th. And he's back out there. Here's Kucherov trying to settle it inside. And double point. Back over. Scores! Braden Point opens the scoring at Amalie Arena. It's 1-0 Lightning.
You know, there's little plays within this sequence here. As this puck is chipped in, it's a little push there by Hagel that keeps that puck in the offensive zone. It's kind of a bouncing situation. And when you have Point in front all alone, you can see how opportunistic he is. Binnington's slow to get across because that puck is, there's so much uncertainty in that play. And Tampa strikes first.
Both teams coming off of losses. The Lightning lost in this building on Monday against the Boston Bruins, and St. Louis lost to Buffalo. Here come the Lightning again. In their pass to Kulak, he scores! Two quick goals by the Lightning, and it is 2-0.
Well, quick start here for the Tampa Bay Lightning. When you look at this player, you can see how Tampa's coming in and pushing that puck. And really trying to keep it below the hash marks. And there's just puck management. Falk is a backhand pass through the middle of the ice that comes back and ends up hurting you. No chance there for Binnington as you get the option. You see the option here for Paul. He knows where he's going with that puck. And Killorn does too. He's sitting there quietly. And that's too quick.
Yeah! Off the battle. Past him and push himself past O'Reilly. And here comes Point again. Braden Point in and he fired it high. Wow, this place would have exploded if they had scored a third straight. Stamkos already got an assist tonight. Back down 4 points. Braden Point. Back to Stamkos. Look, shoots, and Binnington made the stop. Rebound to the line. Across for Stamkos. Sharply in front. Missed the target. And it's picked up by Kucherov. Back and forth with Sergachev. Into the slot. Point scores! Braden Point. Power play goal. Of the period, and the Lightning are up by 3. Paul leaves it for Ross Colton. Steps in over the line. Colton dishes out to Maroon. Bouncing puck in. Binnington makes the stop there on a roller.
So it's a late start today. You wait all day to get here. They're coming off a bad loss. Here we go.
This is Shen up the ice. Shen shoots in. That one goes up and off the blocker of Vasilevsky.
Here's that rush. It's an odd man rush. First one of the night. And Shen is going to decide to shoot it. Why not when things aren't going very well? Keep it simple.
Middle down and move near side for Jordan Kyrou. Looks back to the line for the veteran Falk. Kyrou
up top, they'll step in. Feed down low, side tip, and scores! Pavel Buchnevich with a power play goal, and St. Louis is on the board.
Buchnevich immediately gives credit. As this play is going to happen, that's Thomas who slides that down. And you can see Buchnevich, he just got to open that blade up a little bit. Robert Thomas, fake shot, he sells it to the middle of the ice, kind of clogs it up with that play, and as Buchnevich is moving into the puck, he just ramps it off the stick, makes it look easy. See how he appears from behind the net?
Here's Cole. Cole hangs on, walks it in, throws it in there on Binnington, and he will hang on for the whistle. Picked up now by Colton. Colton trying to get the return feed there from Pat Maroon. And Thomas back in there. Thomas hangs on. Looks back to the lead man. It's Kyrou. His shot scores! Jordan Kyrou buries it and makes it a one-goal game. 3-2.
As Thomas picks up the puck with speed, and then that's that stretch play. Kind of relieves the pressure in the defensive zone. Gets an early and easy entry. And Kyrou, the late man, the second wave attack. You can see Thomas looking for him, and there he gets it. And what a look at that goal. Just beneath the blocker. Right there above the pad.
And with that goal, Kyrou will take over the team lead in goal scoring. And now is a chance for Boyd. Boyd in, and he fired it wide. Here's a turnover. Hagel with a drive. Scores! The Lightning answer right back at a goal by Brandon Hagel, and it's 4-2.
But after that, you can see as he steals the puck, he tries to go far side. Now this puck is kept in by Kucherov. He's such a smart player, he anticipates that wide shot, but not only getting the puck, he immediately sifts it towards the middle of the ice, and Hagel, you see what he's doing there. He just wires it as hard as he can.
Just under 13 minutes remaining in the second period. Binnington with a bang pass, and now it's Shen. Shen in, and he's stopped by Vasilevsky. He got in too tight.
Blues Braden Shen gets a pass from Binnington, the netminder. He's got all kinds of time. He shifts Vasilevsky to his right, and then goes back to Vasilevsky's left, but he stays right with him. See Shen here, fake shot. There goes Vasilevsky to the right, but just competes to close that door.
As I'm standing here.
Robert Bortuzzo. Now the Blues got something cooking here. Back up top. Bortuzzo shot right on. And Vasilevsky makes that save. Another drive. Big stop by Vasilevsky. Another blast. And he got that too. Bowser sent in wide of the Lightning net. Into the corner. Buchnevich sends it out in front for Kyrou. And did that just played 4.5 seasons here with the Lightning and Ryan McDonough. Not a bad list.
That definitely helped his plus minus here with Hedman and Kucherov.
O'Reilly with a good pass into the middle for Shen. Shen steps in, drops it off. Here's the shot saved by Vasilevsky, and that good release from Tarasenko.
And that one he steered out of play on purpose to get his teammates a break. But that last one.
Do not go away quietly.
Yeah, that's right. You want to test your mettle a little bit. This is a team that struggled for 8 games, came back and won 7. They've lost the last one, and now this is important.
Here comes Hagel, up the middle. Brandon Hagel in, stopped by Binnington. Minutes without a whistle, guys, and there's been lots of actions, including this breakaway by Brandon Hagel and a stop by Binnington. Kucherov. 3 points, 9 to go. In front, and what a chance in front there for Maroon. And it goes just wide.
How about that spinorama, tape to tape?
As well, what a game we got going on the NHL on TNT. Down by 2. Binnington on the bench. Blues with the puck. Inside the Lightning blue line, there's a wrist shot knocked down. Stamkos, the other to Kalon, empty net. Nick Paul steps in. 5-2.
From the faceoff, you're going to see this. Excellent job here trying to execute this play. And as they look to the net, Buchnevich is just trying to find something there. And as it gets blocked, it's clean and out of the zone. And unfortunately, you look at the 4-minute mark now, I think it's a little early.
Yeah, Nick Paul's just been a terror tonight, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's impressed.
St. Louis has made the playoffs 10 of the last 11 seasons.
Here's Stamkos. Kamesnikov got the second attempt away. And Binnington makes the save. Final seconds kick off the clock, and that'll do it for our Thanksgiving showdown on the NHL on TNT. Our producer tonight, Joe Whalen, our director, Doug Yulacki, and our entire excellent crew here tonight at Amalie Arena.
NHL's two newest teams, the top two teams in the Pacific Division right now. Carlson rolls up. Here's Marchessault's shot, and Grubauer got a piece of it. Theodore to Carlson. Plays it out to the right point. Larson looking. Wrist shot tipped wide. It's Dunn pinching in. Bjorkstrand in deep. Bjorkstrand ended a 17-game drought for him last time out. Larson a shot. Bruce puck score, and it's Ryan Donato. Picks it up at the top of the crease. Goals in back-to-back games for Donato, and the Kraken on the board first.
Little low to high, quick shot by Larson at the point. You see it blocked by Martinez, and Donato does a good job from behind.
On a Wednesday night, now Donato into the offensive end, rolling into the corner against Nick A. Daniel Sprong centered it. Morgan Geeky with a shot, and Hill got a piece of that. Now Winberg. Schultz for Beniers, and across the seam to Sprong. Feeds it on net. Good pad save by Hill. Daniel Sprong. Schultz straight away to Winberg, and back to Schultz again. Walks it in a little bit. Wrist shot deflected. Sam Hill. And the rebound cleared up, but not out by Hague. Sprong drive deflected out of play. Alexiak lets it fly. That's blocked in front. The Kraken lost four of their first five this year. They got points out of some of those. They were 1-2-2. They've gone 11-3-1 since. Tanev feeds it down low. Board flips it across. Well, Jared McCann was looking for what would have been his team-leading eighth. That didn't miss by much. Larson at center. Into the Vegas end. Burakovsky walking in. Shot! Score! And broke through Hill. Andre Burakovsky. Seattle's top scorer so far this year has made it 2-0.
Odd man rush the other way. Burakovsky likes to hang on. See that middle lane drive? That shot goes through a couple of players. Golden Knight and Wenberg driving the net. Beats Hill. And it's 2-0 Seattle.
Andre Burakovsky. Out into the zone. Connor snapped it wide. Follow-up chance from Kessel, and Grubauer was there. Awa for Smith. Theodore straight away. Holding. Feeds it down. Low Castle with a tip shot. Rebound score. Nick Wall back in the lineup. A power play goal with 7 seconds left on the man advantage to cut the Seattle lead in half.
Great play at the point by Shane Theodore. They do a good job to alleviate pressure. Watch. They spread out. They take away Smith and Kessel. So that's a clear lane. Great little pass. This is a shot pass for the high tip. Carlson and then Nick Waugh parked right in front, able to get the rebound. But a real good read up top by Shea Theodore. They take away the flanks.
All the way around under the reach of Tanev. And Philip Grubauer out to play. It's his first turn in over a month for Grubauer. Had been playing his best game with Seattle when he was injured in Colorado earlier this year. Had to leave the game with about 10 minutes left. Theodore wrist in a front score!
More momentum, and it starts behind the net. Grubauer plays his puck. It goes past Everly right to the point. Good little move to get down as Theodore drives in. He does the work. The puck comes off his stick right to Phil Kessel, and he lets it go to beat Grubauer to the blocker side.
And Kessel will start it out. Cross ice pass to Smith as Carlson breaking towards the net. Another backhand. Grubauer kicked that one out.
Cross ice pass right tape to tape to Smith, who gets it inside to Carlson. There's that little spin.
Back the other way comes Gord. Cut off by Cotter. Bjorkstrand into the offensive end, driving wide. And Hill gloves that on the short side post. Towards the corner, plays it to Carrier behind the Kraken net. Trying to fight his way out in front, put it right in the crease! And Grubauer covers it. Kolesar was digging away.
Wrong on the puck. There's no hesitation. Simplify the game. Get the puck to the net. And you see right there, Carlson in a battle with Dunn and Larson of the Kraken. And he just can't get a stick on it.
Stone picks it up. Theodore out top. His shot. Blocker save Grubauer.
McNabb stepping up to keep it in. Now Carson Soucy up the glass, but not out. And Everly banks it down the wall. Jared McCann into the offensive end. His shot turned away by Aiden Hill. Now Everly with a chance. Blocked in front. That hit his own man in Beniers. They've won all five meetings with a Kraken, and they won't see each other again until the end of the season. A home and home with the Kraken to end the regular year in the middle of April. Theodore Cross. Haig has room. Shot blocked in front. Oleksiak and a sidestep. Eichel to center. Eichel at the end of his shift. Oleksiak carries it in deep. Rolls into the corner. Burakovsky a little room. Shot. Score! A little bit of daylight, and Andre Burakovsky snaps it home. His second of the game. Seattle with the lead again.
Oleksiak comes in, and then watch both Haig and Smith drop down. That leaves Burakovsky wide open, and he comes in and he goes short side up over the left shoulder of Hill. And able to walk to right below that faceoff dot. And he's been red hot.
Have not made a goaltending change in game this season.
Everly out high, throwing it towards the net. Hill gloves it. Here's Riley Smith. 3-on-3 come the Golden Knights. Carlson, a buck down. Smith, center it! And Theodore robbed by Grubauer.
Aja in as Smith drops as Tanev's coming right at him, but he stays on. He gets the puck with a one-hand pass, and it comes to the...
Burakovsky gains the line, feeds it down the wall. Petrangelo, hounded by Wenberg. Burakovsky gets it back. Larson spins. Schwartz with a drive on, and a save made by Hill. Larson and Dunn around the horn for Wenberg. Back out high to McCann, and a glove save. Hill. He snared that one. Jay looking for his first goal in the 11th. And the puck deflected out of play for a whistle. Just under 9 minutes to go now. Now Stevenson in deep. It went by him to Larson. Eichel picks it up. Zips it to Martinez. Theodore for the one-timer. And a save. Grubauer got a good look at that blast. Carrier rolls loose. Little feed to Phil Kessel out high. Theodore with room. A shot! And a save. Grubauer! Michael Amadio and Paul Cotter break through center. Cotter racing into the corner with Adam Larson. Amadio behind the net trying to feed Kessel. Just tipped off his stick. Larson moves it out. Amadio with a steal. Amadio looking to break. Has Kessel with him. Kessel walking in. Shot! And a blocker save. Grubauer! Tried to go low stick side on Hill, and Hill was able to push that loose puck out of danger. Beniers shoveling it off. Everly looking down low. Backhand! Hill with a great save, and Everly scores on the rebound! Jordan Everly, 5 goals now in his last 7. And the Kraken up by 2.
Turnover just inside the blue line. Kept alive by McCann. Great feet, and then Everly, some good hands, patience.
But after a slow start to the season, up to 6 goals on the year. 5 of those have come in his last 7. Another turnover here by the Golden Knights. And Hill holds tight. And just 2 shots from the fourth line for the Golden Knights. The Golden Knights had 5 wins this year when trailing in the third.
Just a much different team from us earlier in the season.
Burakovsky rolls it back out high. Dunn, a wrist shot off the post. And now Burakovsky shot, and Hill get a piece of that.
Vince Dunn, he lets one go through some traffic in front, off the glove side post on Hill.
Wah, Kessel, Geeky along the wall. And Theodore one hands it up and not out. Donato keeps it in, shot, but save Hill. Winning in the fortress, 4-2, and Philip Grubauer has his first win of this season.
A well-deserved win for the Seattle Kraken. They were the better team here today.
The Jets were a little mixed up in their defensive zone coverage, kind of mid-change. Schmidt for Winnipeg, off a stick out to center ice. Wheeler feeds it left side, cutting in, a backhand score! What a move by Cole Perfetti. And just a buck 32 into the game, Perfetti and the Jets strike first. Of the Winnipeg Jets when these two teams met up in the peg, and perhaps feeling like they had some forward help coming back, but Hockenpah and Lindell were close together guarding the middle of the rink, and the pass was made, thread the needle to Perfetti.
There's a very curious stat line between these two teams in the short season series so far. The team that has scored first has not scored again in either game. Here's a shot, stop, rebound, score! And it's an immediate answer from Wyatt Johnston.
Two on one, so are we, is basically what the Stars stated. Big pass up through neutral ice. Jamie Benn creates the rebound, just firing it off those hard pads of Hellebuck. And it is a corpulent rebound off to the right. What a great chance for Sam Gagne to play on that line with Dubois and Connor. I don't think that's what they had in mind. Giveaway and a chance, score! Jansen Harkins.
The Stars couldn't spot the puck. It was moved to the free man. And Harkins restores the Winnipeg lead.
You know, it's a simple dump in. Great hustle initially to get in and sort of puck jack Ryan Suter. Suter was wondering why this wasn't icing, I guess. He was arguing with the referee. Perhaps there should have been a penalty on him. But he got beat to that. Ottinger didn't play it. It was a rather large bounce off the end board.
Stars hold the zone. Over to Pavelski. He'll angle it. Haskinen with some space. Feeds it Robertson for Benn. Save. Rebound. Score! Power play goal for Jamie Benn. The Stars on the Benn advantage.
It was Jamie's power play goal the other night that got them started offensively. And this is another juicy rebound with Hellebuck going the wrong way and nobody helping out in tight. He got swimming back in there a little bit. Nobody followed up on Ben's original. Little bunt to the net, gets to the back end. I mean, when you're going, you're going.
Worked it low and broken up on a centering pass. Kept alive and unsure. Got over. Puck is still loose. And finally for the whistle. What a save on Kyle Connor by Ottinger. And it's Lundqvist, Robertson. Tap cut down by Dillon. Stars shoot in Haskinen just as he was about to make a change. And that puck, they want to say out of play. The Stars shoot and score. Robertson. There was no signal. The Jets were sure that puck was out of play.
Came in and tried that. The shot, the goal. They're having a conference, all the Zebras at center ice.
At 14:43, the puck left the playing surface and struck the net behind the goal. No goal.
Lowry on it on the outside hash marks. Around where Harkins grabs it. His goal tonight, his first of this season, 11th of his NHL career. And in front, Lowry just got enough with the long reach to tap it past Ottinger. And the Jets are back on the board and back in front.
And this is just getting beat in coverage at the net. Lowry funnels it or rims it around deep and then goes to the front of the net. Ryan Suter's right next to him and he just gets away from him. The original shot from the blue line is a marshmallow deflected perfectly for a spinning Adam Lowry. That's a cute little setup and not much chance.
Gurianov swept quickly to Marchment. Marchment across. Gurianov shot off the bar. Rebound. And it stayed out. The puck remains loose. Sagan had a stab at it. And somehow that puck stayed clear. They might call this one back.
Well, really late. Nice work by Gurianov to slalom his way in and get it set up. And then move the puck briskly from that. Use the width. Rip it on net. Ding, square off the pipe. If it hits Tyler Sagan in the skate first, he probably has a better shot at it. Instead, he just finds it, boots it, and that paddle of
DeMello for Gagne, tapped it for Dubois, centers and score, Connor. Kyle Connor extends the Winnipeg lead. It's 4-2 Jets.
A hungrier drive to the net. He had Jason Robertson on his back trying to cover. Stars aggressive with their defenseman standing up, and a sweet backhand. That is a savory little toss to Connor. And Ottinger didn't get out and jam him on that. He was right on his goal line, essentially.
Stars up to 36 shots. Hellebuck at 34 saves. Stars win another faceoff. Robertson sends it low. Sagan now back up high. Out of the box is Schmidt. It's now a 6-on-5. Robertson shot. Score! Ben was set up in front. Took Hellebuck's eyes away. And Jason Robertson, long-range wrister, has Dallas within the goal.
He's unbelievable. He is a petroleum-based scorer. There's just a vaselinity to a shot. Wrister, you're right. Ben takes all the vision away from Hellebuck. Stars bench celebrates. They know they're within.
Long pass angled for Hintz. To the left side, Sagan settles it down. Sagan trying to stay with it. Now Haskinen. Stick handles, a backhand save made. Rebound loose, kept alive. And here's Robertson. Score! Hellebuck is down, face down. His helmet is off behind the net. But Robertson and the Stars have tied it with 18 and a half seconds to play.
Jets are going to challenge this for goalie interference. Hellebuck was trying to get to the rebound. Jamie trying to get behind the net and track down the puck. Just basically went right straight through the skull of Connor Hellebuck. They didn't blow it dead. The play continued.
We'll find out now.
After video review with the situation room, it has been determined that the actions of Winnipeg number 44 caused the incidental contact with the goaltender. The
goal on the ice. 3.4 seconds to go. Glendening wins it cleanly. And indeed, the final meeting needs extra time. It was a winding, scenic route to get there. Press through traffic. Wheeler steals it away. He's got Morrissey racing. Feeds it up there. Morrissey charging, trying to pull away from Robertson. He does. He scores. Josh Morrissey wins it for the Jets. 34 seconds into overtime. And the Stars have to settle for a point.
Put him down, and Jason Robertson tried valiantly to get back. Couldn't match the speed. The speed backed Ottinger. His drift back. The five hole was available, and he went right between the legs to end this immediately in OT.
Featured on the top line for LA here tonight with this group is Mikey Anderson, who's paired on defense with Drew Doughty. Sends it in. It's clear to the line. Doughty kept it in, and now it's picked up again by Fiala into the middle. Anderson, they score on the first shift of the game. Kempe, and it's 1-0 Kings.
At the game, watch the jump from the point right in. That creates the 2-on-1. Sharks get a little bit puck monopolized. Everybody's looking at the puck. There's no depth away from the puck. And a really nice play by the LA Kings. Adrian Kempe disappears and then reappears, gets in for that chance. The Sharks, I think, are like maybe looking that there could be an offside here. There might be a challenge.
After video review, coach's challenge, it was determined that the play was offside. Therefore, we have no goal. Set the clock to 19:47.
Carlson back to Meyer again. Barabanov with it. Sharks had a clinical 4-on-3 goal the other night. And Quick gets across to deny Meyer there on his first big save of the night. That one's blocked at the Sharks line. Back to Fiala. And on to Durzi again. Sharks get it back. Hurdle in the zone with Meyer. Sends it back to the point. Loose puck. And a great save by Quick off Timo Meyer's backhand. Durzi, the former Maple Leaf prospect. He'll work it out front. Geno tips it for Arvidsson. He'll wheel it back for Phil Deneau. Jersey, a drive off the goalpost. It remains a 0-0 game. The Kings did put a puck in the net, but it was called back on an offside challenge by the Sharks. And Anderson Dolan scores. And now it's 1-0 LA.
Breakout, and look at this pass by Drew Doughty. Snaps it right to the middle. And this is just a heck of a shot. Shoot the puck, use the guy, the defender, as the screen, get it between his legs, change his direction. Watch the shot. Between the legs, to the short side.
Making contact with the Sharks' blue liner as Šimek sends it round. Took a bad hop off the glass. But the Sharks do clear it back into neutral ice. Here's a breakaway for Barabanov. In alone. And quick looks behind him. He made the save. Meyer's open. Back for Hurdle and over LeBanc. Meyer skating behind the Kings net through a stick check by Roy. Now in front, LeBanc shoots, scores! Kevin LeBanc, and it's 1-1.
David Quinn wants his guys to make plays below the hash marks. And this line, Hurdle, LeBanc, and Meyer are big. They're strong. When they get below the hash marks, they're very tough to defend against. Kevin LeBanc has got a fantastic shot. Look at how he releases from in front. He gains some space. He doesn't stay right up close to Kopitar.
Kaliev paddles it to Edler. That's deflected wide. Anderson Dolan, a wraparound try. Reimer made the save. It's back to the net again. And Reimer stopped that one from Anderson Dolan. Kaliev again. Durzi, right-handed shot. Everyone will pull that off the boards. Arvidsson back for Deneau, and he scores. Beats Reimer over the glove hand, and it's 2-1 Kings on a power play goal. What a career. What a bonanza.
Ah, there you go. Very good.
Back underway here at the Shark Tank. Kempe protecting against Couture, and he sends it back. Kings making a change over at their bench, as the Sharks do as well here in the second period. Fiala to Arvidsson. One man back. Carlson, he pulls the trigger and scores through James Reimer. And that one hurts. 3-1 LA.
The goalie, when they're the shots that you know the goalie 90% of the time will stop, that one he doesn't. It just goes through him. Those sink a bench. The whole bench is kind of sagged a little bit there, Randy. Nice play by Arvidsson. Pulls it and then tries to use Erik Karlsson as a screen, but James, it's too bad. They want to go down low, finally get in the offensive zone. Go low high, but the puck just jumped.
Megna lost it. Anderson Dolan, a shot and a toe saved by Reimer. Nino battling Philip Deneau.
Get over there to help him.
Greger does. Bonino still going at it with Deneau. Now Noah Greger, a backhand try. And Quick was there. Bonino now out front. A nice look for Cunnan. And Quick is there to make the stop. Inside the final minute here of period two. Sharks trying to get back to within a goal. Kopitar. A near turnover by Durzi. And he gave it away! And Barabanov scores! Alexander Barabanov, opportunistic there. And it's 3-2.
Did the Sharks need? They needed this, a goal in the last 40 seconds of the game. Just a horrendous, heinous giveaway. Alexander Barabanov, though, look at how the stick just betrays Durzi on that. Stick flex off the heel, and it's almost a pass and a one-timer in by Barabanov. That's a big goal for the Sharks. That'll give them a lift.
There was to have been a 14th game earlier today, Colorado at Nashville, but a water main broke at Bridgestone Arena in Nashville, flooding the arena to some degree. He might be having the game of his career here tonight, Drew. He's got a goal, five shots, three hits, two blocks for Jared Anderson Dolan.
He's been very impressive. Moves his feet all the time. Hold it.
Here he passes, and they score! Through the five hole. That's Kupari. And it's 4-2.
James Reimer comes out. This is a five-hole goal. Another one goes through him. He's just got to have this, Randy. He's just got to have this. Right off the bat, though, as soon as that goal goes in, the guys drop their heads. Nick Benito say, come on, boys.
Carlson backhands to center. Meyer can't catch it. Matt Roy back.
Got to get more people there quicker.
Hurdle almost tucked that in. And Quick alertly had his skate up against the post to prevent it. That's the perfect Natty Hattie, isn't it? Kaliev and Reimer comes up with a big save off Anderson Dolan, who's been all over it tonight.
Almost halfway through the third period here.
The entry to Couture. Works his way in. Back for Carlson. He'll shoot. Saved by Quick. Rebound. Barabanov dumps it back to the side. Couture's there. He'll flick it around to Carlson. Under 9.5 left now in the third. As the Sharks try and take down the Kings for the first time this season. A giveaway, and Vilardi works it to the net, but it's saved by Reimer. Carlson from center. Good stick whip there by Kempe. Off the glove of Carlson. Now he's looking for the puck. Kopitar's got it, and he puts it in the empty net. And that ought to be enough for L.A. It's 5-2.
Hey, Mikey Anderson got,
I think he did. Got a piece of that.
And before that, Erik Karlsson got slapped.
And that's going to be it as Arvidsson takes one more shot, and this one is over. The Kings score first, and then they opened it up